One day, James was waiting in the shed for his driver and fireman. Once his driver and fireman arrived, they lit James's fire. "We have to wait here, James," said his driver. "Why do we have to wait?" asked James. "Sir Topham Hatt has a job for us to do." "What sort of job?" asked James. "I don't know. We will have to see when he arrives." A few moments later, the Fat Controller arrived. "Hello, James," said the Fat Controller. "Hello, sir. Driver tells me you have a job for me to do." "Yes, I do, James. You are to pull a goods train."
"A goods train?"
"Yes, a goods train. But sir, I am a splendid red engine. Can't Thomas take it?" "Thomas is busy at the docks helping with the shipment of building supplies." "How about Henry? He likes goods trains," said James. "Henry is taking the express," said the Fat Controller. "How about..." started James. "James, you are the only engine that is available. The train is waiting for you at the coal yards." And then the Fat Controller turned and walked away. And James set off to the coal yards. When James arrived, Duck was shunting his train. "Here's your trucks, James," said Duck. "Thanks, now get out of my way." Duck switched tracks, and James backed down to the train. When James backed down to the train, he gave the cars a bump. "Oh, oh, oh," cried the trucks. "Be careful with the trucks, they've given me a lot of trouble," said Duck. "I know how to handle trucks," said James. With a toot of James's whistle, he set off for Nafford Station. The trucks were cross with James. "Let's pay James out." "Let's pay him out," said the trucks. Once James arrived at Gordon's Hill, his driver warned him, "Be careful, James, we don't want to have an accident." But James wasn't listening, he was thinking about pulling the express. Once James got to the top of Gordon's Hill, his driver applied his brakes. But the trucks bumped James hard, so hard that his driver's hand slipped off the brakes and the handle snapped off. "On, on, on," said the truck. "Stop, stop, stop," said James. "I've got to stop, I've got to stop," cried James. Through the station they thundered. What was that? As James rounded a bend, his front wheels flew off the tracks. Luckily, no one was hurt. His driver and fireman had jumped clear before the crash. James's driver went back to the station to call for help. Soon after, Duck arrived with the breakdown train. "I thought you knew how to handle trucks," teased Duck, but James pretended he didn't hear. Once James was back on the tracks, Duck pushed him to the station, where the Fat Controller was waiting for them. "I'm sorry, sir," said James. It's not your fault, James, said the Fat Controller. The handle snapped off your brakes. You will be sent to the works to be mended and get a new coat of paint. And Duck, you will be sent to the works with James to be repainted too. Oh, thank you, sir, they both said. Once James and Duck had returned from the works, James apologized to Duck for being so rude to him. And every time Duck gave James a warning, James listened to him.